Good day, everyone. Welcome back to True Celebrity Stories. It's great to meet again. In this video, we'll be talking about the disappearance of the Corrs. But first, subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to get notified whenever a new video is uploaded. The Corrs rose to international fame in the early 2000s thanks to a string of hit singles that helped them sell more than 30 million copies. Let's take a look back at their past and see what they're up to now. The band became one of the top-selling bands in the world during the 1990s, made up of the four Corrs siblings: lead vocalist Andrea, violinist Sharon, drummer Caroline, and guitarist Jim. It should never have worked in the first place. A fiddle-playing family performing in the local pub isn't exactly a recipe for international fame. The Corrs' folksy, diddly-eyed charms, on the other hand, ensured them that. The band progressed from playing at their aunt's pub, McManus's, in Dundalk, Cove Louth, to selling out venues all over the world and having albums certified platinum. Talk on Corners was the best-selling album in the UK in 1998, and the most successful Irish album in UK history, selling more than U2 and Westlife combined. In Blue, their third album, which is more pop-oriented, reached number 1 in 17 countries. They were very big as far as nice small Irish bands go. The Corrs won several accolades and gained a slew of celebrity fans, including their compatriot U2's Bono, while achieving global success with a slew of infectious pop compositions full of inspiration from their Irish heritage, before taking an almost 10-year hiatus. The Corrs are an Irish family from Dundalk, County Louth. While Caroline and Andrea were still in school, Jim and Sharon began performing as a duo, frequently at their aunt's pub, McManus's. Jim and Sharon formed a quartet with their younger siblings in 1990. When they auditioned for the film The Commitments in 1991, their career took off. As musicians, Jim, Sharon, and Caroline each had minor roles, while Andrea had a speaking role as Sharon Rabbit. When they auditioned for the film, John Hughes noticed them and decided to become their manager. After witnessing them perform at Wayland's Music Bar in Dublin, the United States Ambassador to Ireland, Jean Kennedy Smith, encouraged them to perform at the 1994 FIFA World Cup in Boston. The Corrs joined Celine Dion's worldwide Falling Into You Around the World tour as a supporting act after performing at the 1996 Summer Olympics in Atlanta, Georgia. According to Jason Flom, Atlantic Records' head of A&R recommended they meet David Foster, a Canadian musician, producer, composer, and arranger. Foster agreed to sign the Corrs to Atlantic Records after they performed live for him. They stayed in the United States for over 5 months to record Forgiven, Not Forgotten, their debut album. Among the Celtic-influenced tracks, there were 6 instrumental selections. In Ireland, Australia, Canada, Japan, Norway, and Spain, the album was well received. However, a major success in the United States and the United Kingdom did not come quickly. The album eventually went platinum in the UK and Australia, and 4 platinum in Ireland, making it one of the most successful debut albums ever by an Irish group. Furthermore, Glenn Ballard, who was known for his work with Alanis Morissette, produced the Corrs' second album, Talk on Corners, in 1997. Carol Bayer-Sager, Oliver Leiber, Rick Knowles, and Billy Steinberg also worked with the Corrs. It was a hit in Ireland and the United Kingdom, and it reached number 3 on the Australian album charts. The band re-released Talk on Corners with new remixes of What Can I Do, So Young, and Runaway after recording a rendition of Dreams for a Fleetwood Mac tribute album. The special edition topped the charts all over the world and was certified multi-platinum in the United Kingdom and Australia. The Corrs performed at the Pavarotti and Friends for the Children of Liberia charity concert in June 1998. Luciano Pavarotti hosted the event, which took place in Modena, Italy. Jon Bon Jovi, Celine Dion, The Spice Girls, and Stevie Wonder were among the other performers. The event was held to raise funds for the construction of the Pavarotti and Friends Liberian Children's Village, which will serve as a haven for children in Liberia. The Corrs won a Brit Award for Best International Band the following year. On October 5, 1999, in Ardmore Studios in County Wicklow, Ireland, they performed live on MTV's Unplugged. The resulting CD and DVD sold 2.7 million copies and included live renditions of previously published songs, as well as a new song, Radio, which would later appear on the third album, In Blue. With their 1997 album, Talk on Corners, which was the best-selling album of that year, and their 1995 debut, Forgiven, Not Forgotten, the Corrs held the top 2 spots on the UK album chart, one of only a few groups to do so. Following the success of their debut album, the Corrs went on to support Celine Dion on her 1996-97 Falling Into You Around the World tour, as we mentioned earlier, and never looked back, winning a Brit Award for Best International Band in 1999. Runaway, What Can I Do, Breathless, and Only When I Sleep had helped them achieve massive success with 5 platinum albums: In Blue from 2000, Borrowed Heaven from 2004, and Home from 2005, and more than 40 million sales. While Borrowed Heaven and Home didn't receive the same level of critical praise as their previous two albums, the Corrs were still doing well when they decided to put down their tin whistles and violins in 2006 to pursue individual careers and raise their kids. Jim, 52, had a son, Brandon, and learned to fly helicopters during their sabbatical, as well as losing a lot of money in Irish property when the real estate bubble burst. Caroline, 43, already had 2 children, Jake, 13, and Georgina, 12, when the band went on hiatus, and she didn't spend any time having a third when her daughter Ryan was born on December 1st, 2006. Sharon, 46, used the opportunity to have 2 children, Cathal, 10, Flory, 8, as well as produce 2 solo albums and serve as a coach on Ireland's version of The Voice. Andrea, the group's youngest member at 42, had a 4-year-old daughter Jean and a 2-year-old son Brett Jr. She also released 2 solo albums and focused on theater acting when they weren't taking the world by storm. "I loved the solo albums, but they weren't the albums the record corporation wanted," she explained. "I was completely deflated. It takes the wind out of your sails. You've lost your desire to sing." Andrea has later stated that one of the reasons the group disbanded was due to burnout, telling Everett magazine, "It was burnout. It happens to bands all the time. You don't stop working and you certainly won't stop touring." Back in the group's heyday, the raven-haired beauty was often romantically linked to the likes of Robbie Williams and even Bono, but she found celebrity culture tough to handle. But she and the band preserved, and one of their greatest accomplishments was that they were still talking to each other when they took a hiatus, which Sharon once called our most astonishing success, raising the prospect of a return to the stage. However, there were periods during the band's absence when it appeared that a reunion would never happen. Andrea admitted in 2011 that her siblings were very pleased being a mother and a daddy, and she didn't sound optimistic about a revival of the Corrs happening anytime soon. Sharon put an album out last year and she enjoyed doing that, she told the Telegraph's Stella magazine. "Commercial success isn't everything, she's the mother of 2 children. That is the most excellent creation. Jim is self-employed and the father of 1 child. Caroline, on the other hand, has 3 children and is very happy." But the rumors persisted, and during a radio interview in early 2015, Andrea eventually revealed the band was working on a new album and intended to perform at London's Hyde Park after months of speculation. The Corrs were dealt a major setback before returning to the stage when their father Jerry died unexpectedly at the age of 82. But rather than sending them out the studio exit door, the tragedy pushed them forward. "My father advised us to go for it and do what we love," Jim explained. "It's fortunate that they both survived to see us succeed and that Dad was able to hear us perform together once more before he died." In November 2015, the band released their 6th studio album, White Light, which was dedicated to their father, just as they had done with their 2005 album Home, which was dedicated to their mother Jean, who died in 1999 while awaiting a lung transplant. White Light, however, did not set the globe on fire with its chart positions despite its name. The album was only placed at 11th in the UK album charts and at 18th in Australia, where the trio had previously found success with Forgiven, Not Forgotten, which was the 3rd best-selling album in Australia in 1996. Despite this, the Corrs embarked on a 34-city European tour in 2016 that ended in August. Despite the record failing to reach the top 10, the band seemed unfazed as they published a photo of themselves in the studio earlier this month on their Twitter account, which has barely 9,000 followers. While the irresistible hitmakers decided to let the photographs speak for themselves, leaving the captions blank, they indicate that there may be more projects on the horizon when their tour concludes in August. We've made it to the end of the video, so what do you think is next for this family band? Will they bounce back and dominate world charts like before? Let us know in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like and subscribe. Oh, and turn on post notifications. Now, if you'll excuse me, thank you for watching, I'll see y'all in the next video.